This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Hi everyone, it's Vernon and I'm really happy you've remembered that a new week means a new podcast. And today's episode, taken from Monday the 5th of June, is a special one. You're going to enjoy it because... What's that smell? I think it could be the waft of a high score coming down the corridor. Not sure, we'll have to wait and see. Don't forget that if you want every episode to appear on your device automatically, all you've got to do is hit the subscribe button and it will pop up on your device.
BBC Radio 2, 10 to the top.
It's a brand new week, which means we have cleared the leaderboard. Last week's high score was 25 points. The week before that, I had a full board of 65 points. So let's see how we fare this week. Let's see if we can just do better than last week's high score of 25 points. The first person to step up to the plate is Adam Carpenter from Helston in Cornwall. How are you, Adam?
I'm very well, Vernon. How are you?
I'm very good. Now, Adam, we've got lots to talk about. First things first is you work in trust and safety at Epic Games. And Epic Games are the developers, the producers of Fortnite. Every parent listening who's got a gaming console in their house will know about Fortnite. What an epic, epic, epic game. Cue the pun.
Yeah, it is. It's a massive game, really popular, and a real privilege to be in a position where I'm able to keep everyone playing it or help keep everyone playing it safe and happy. It's a wonderful job.
And I would imagine that trust and safety is all about making sure that the people playing it are in a safe space when they game.
Exactly, yeah. Whatever their age, it's making sure everyone isn't under threat of any nastiness. It's all happy and fair and just a nice environment to game in.
Let's talk about music. You are music obsessed.
Yes, absolutely.
What's your bag? What kind of stuff? If I was to look at your playlist now on one of those streaming websites, what would be on the playlist that you've built?
Top of the list would be Taylor Swift, but mainly because my daughter Karis absolutely loves Taylor Swift, and literally back-to-back Taylor kind of seeps through onto everyone's playlist. But if it was down to me, there'd be lots of ABBA there, Elton John. I love 80s music, so I dip back into that quite a bit. But also I keep up to date with what's going on in the charts, so I kind of know who's in the top 10, and I always am keen on finding new tracks to listen to.
Right, are you ready to get involved? You're the first contestant of the week, so it's up to you to set the standard and raise the bar on Monday.
Pressure.
Yeah, our first contestant. All right, so good luck. Here we go.
Ten to the top on Radio 2.
Remember, it's 10 to the top. It's your climb to 10 questions. Let's see how many points you can get right. You can play your joker at any time you want, and that will double the amount of points available in that particular question. It's dead, dead simple. So wishing you all the very best. Here we go. Your first question for a point. Meghan Trainor made her chart debut in 2014 with the number one song All About That What?
Bass.
Didn't even start
Bass.
The timer. Off the mark. We like that. Well done. 1 point. Next one is worth 2. Before pursuing his solo career, Justin Timberlake was a member of which mega-selling boy band?
NSYNC.
Well done. 2 out of 2. Next one's worth 3 points. In 1982, what kind of arrow did ABC reference on their top 10 song?
Poison.
Yes. And the next question for 4 points is your first clip. Here's the intro to a 1986 song from one of Britain's most successful bands of all time. I just need the title of this tune, please.
Invisible Touch by Genesis.
Well done. 4 points. Right, I'm getting that feeling. I'll be honest with you, Adam. I'm getting that feeling of we've got 4 questions in a row. I'm feeling confident and I'm starting to think we could put together a good run here. So,
fingers crossed.
Yeah, next question is worth 5 points. Joker's still available, but I think the confidence that he's oozing out of the speakers, you're not going to play it just yet.
No, all or nothing.
Yeah, good man. I like your style. Writing to Reach You, Driftwood and Turn were all top 20 hits during 1999 for which band?
Travis.
5 points. Next one's worth 6. On their top 20 hit in 1974, the Isley Brothers sang about a summer what?
Breeze.
Yeah, it was Breeze. Well done. Next one is worth 7. Another Brick in the Wall was a surprise Christmas number one for Pink Floyd. But in what year?
1979.
7 points. For 8 points, Nightbirds in 1982 and Down on the Street in 1984 were both top 10 hits for which group?
Oh, it's one of two. Shack Attack.
Oh, you chose the right one!
Yes, it could have been Shalimar, but no. Oh,
yes, well done. Yeah, well done. That was absolutely awesome. Congratulations.
Thanks.
For 9 points, who reached the top 10 in 1998 with How Do I Live?
Leanne Rimes.
Yes, 9 points. I'm getting that feeling, Adam. 9 points.
Yeah.
I've got to calm myself. All right, calm down. Relax, 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 relax.
Can I play the Joker?
We're going to play the Joker on your last question, which means it's your last clip also. Which means that if you get this right, it's not going to be worth 10 points. It's going to be worth 20 points, which means you will have raised the bar so high that for the rest of the week, it's going to be very, very difficult for all the other contestants to reach a maximum of 65 points. So good luck.
Thank you.
For a full house. Last summer, this next song spent 8 consecutive weeks at number one. I need you to name the act for a full house of 65 points who recorded it.
Is that LF System?
It is indeed LF System!
Yeah!
65 points, there you go! Nail-biting stuff, let's see what's in store for round two. But first, let's listen to this short message from our friends at BBC Sounds.
Hello, I'm Jade Adams. Welcome to the neighbourhood.
I came for banter.
I'll be your tour guide as we explore the peculiar world of local social media groups.
So as long as it's nothing to do with me, reading people arguing soothes me.
I'll be picking up guests along the way, delving into their hometown's dramas.
It's a grenade.
Like Nick Grimshaw and self-esteem.
If you think I should cover this one up, we should see my other one.
Radio 4's Welcome to the Neighbourhood with me, Jade Adams. Listen on BBC Sounds.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the top.
Whew, and relax. Right, Adam scored 65 points. Let's see if our next contestant, Neil Stocken from Retford in Nottinghamshire, can equal that, which will take us to a tie-break situation. Hi, Neil.
Hi, Vernon. You all right?
Yeah, very good, thank you. Neil, you were a DJ throughout the 1990s. What a great decade to be a DJ.
Oh, it has to be the best decade of dance music there's ever been.
Coming out of the summer of love of the late 80s and into the 90s when dance music got a little bit more commercial, but the underground tunes were absolutely banging. Whereabouts did you DJ throughout the 90s?
In my hometown of Worksop, there was a pub called Mr. Moles. it's not there anymore. It was a great venue, so I learned my trade there from the guy who was the DJ at the time. I was residential there for a while. Then I went off doing nightclubs and stuff around Nottinghamshire and South Yorkshire, quite a few pubs and bars in the area. And then at the end, after the night is finished, I went for a few years doing a residential thing, doing weddings and stuff at the cricket club where my dad was the groundsman. So that was a lot more sedate, as you'll understand.
It's a lot more relaxed.
Calm after the storm.
Yeah, exactly. Now, you love travelling. You and your wife, you recently did a tour of the 92 football stadiums across the UK. That's mega.
Yes, Anita and I did that. But what we did it in such a way so that we stayed in the areas as well. Because if it was for me, we'd have done 92 clubs in 4 days, like people do manically. But Anita loves to see different places, so we were staying in the areas. So, like, for instance, when we did Newcastle and Sunderland and all that, we stayed in Durham for a few days. When we did the Welsh clubs like Newport, Cardiff, Swansea, we stayed in a place called Ross-on-Wye in Hereford for a few days and went to a cider festival. It took us about a year, but we got to see a lot of the UK, a lot.
That is a great idea. Using the football stadiums as the spine to your, basically, your annual vacation around the UK. I love that idea.
Yeah, it was really good fun. Expensive, but worth it.
Yeah. Your Kian is 19, lives with his mum, but he's going to University of Leeds in September. Why did he pick Leeds?
He loves Leeds as a city, and the universities that are doing the course that he did, there's not many. And out of the ones that were available, that was the one that was realistically within distance of where his mum lives.
Right.
And also, he went to the different cities and looked at them, and he loves the look of Leeds, because he loves cities, and he thinks Leeds is brilliant. And his friends as well that are going to uni, they're all going to Leeds. So there's about 7 of them going together.
Right, you've got an uphill climb, 65 to take us to a tie break. Are you ready for this?
Yeah, sure.
All right, good lad, let's do it. Here we go.
Ten to the top on Radio 2.
Your first question is worth 1 point. Remember, getting a run is the best thing to do, and you can play your joker wherever you want. 65 points to beat means you might have to put a run together of 9 correct questions, get the 10th one correct with the joker in place. So good luck. First question's worth a point. What sort of operator did Sade sing about on her 1984 hit single?
Smooth.
Yeah, well done. It was smooth, operator, so quick I didn't even have time to play the timer or give you a correct buzzer. There you go. Well done. A point. For 2 points, after he split from the Beatles, what was the name of the 70s band that Paul McCartney formed with his wife, Linda?
Wings. It
was Wings. Question number 3. Complete the title of this top 10 song by The Who from 1971. Won't get what?
Nothing. I don't know.
Unlucky. Won't get fooled again.
No.
Roger Daltrey does a scream on the track, which was recorded while the rest of the band were having lunch outside the studios and heard it from a distance. They genuinely thought he'd thrown a tantrum with the engineer. Next question's worth a point. In 1995, we're going back to 1995, who asked the question, have you ever really loved a woman, on his top 5 single?
I can't think what it is. It
was Bryan Adams.
Of course it was.
Yeah, Bryan Adams. Always gets you when you've got a little bit of extra time. Right, come on, Neil, it's your first clip. Here we go. Let's get a point for this one and then we'll put a run together. 15 years ago this week, Rihanna was at number 1 with the song you're about to hear. I just need the title, please, Neil.
But you put on quite a show. Really had me going. But now it's time to go. Curtains finally closing. That was quite a show.
Neil?
Yeah, people say they're having a blank. I'm having a blank. I can't think of the title.
It was Take a Bow.
Of course it is.
All right, don't worry. Next question's worth a point. Name the singer who teamed up with David Guetta in 2009 for the number 1 tune, When Love Takes Over, and in 2010 on the top 10 song, Commander.
Kelly Rowland.
On again.
Kelly Rowland.
Not there.
I thought you would have got that, being a dance music fan.
Well, I should. I say I'm having a blank.
Right, OK, deep breath. Take a deep breath. Here we go. For a point, in what year did It's a Sin by the Pet Shop Boys spend 3 weeks at number one?
87.
It was 87. Next question's worth 2 points. My Baby Just Cares For Me was a top five hit in 1987. For which legendary musician?
Nina Simone.
It was indeed. Well done. Your penultimate question. David A. Stewart and Candy Dulfer reached the top 10 in 1990 with an instrumental track. What is the three-word title of that track?
Lily Was Here.
Well done, yes, 3 points. Last question, you've got to play your joker now, and it's your last clip. For 8 points. This next artist made her UK chart debut this week in 1994 with the song you're about to hear. What's the singer's name? For 8 points.
No. Oh, it's there.
It is there. You're going to kick yourself when you find out the answer. It was Dawn Penn.
Of course it's Dawn Penn.
And you've played it so many times. I know you have.
I have. Oh. I really have. Sunday nights, we used to have a soul night where everyone could recover from weekend, and they were exactly the kind of things I played all the time, so never mind.
Never mind. If you'd have got that correct, you would have had 17, but instead you got 9 points. 9 points, which is a decent score.
I've had worse.
Yeah, well, there you go. Cheers, there you go. Unfortunately, the mountain was too high for you to climb today. 65 points from Adam was absolutely immense. But listen, Neil, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. Hope everything is tickety-boo with Kian at Leeds Uni. Hope all that goes well. Send my regards to Anita and hopefully keep spinning them records, my friend.
Thanks, Vern. It's been great playing and well done to the other guy. He did brilliant.
Yeah, he did well done. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, congratulations, Adam. Well done, my friend.
Thank you, Vernon. Well done, Neil. They were difficult questions, I thought.
Well, it's luck at draw, Adam. You played very well, mate. You deserve the win.
Oh, thanks.
Love it. That's the one thing I love about this quiz, is everyone's dead friendly at the end. I would imagine that when they put the phone out... Have a cracking week, both of you. Adam, congratulations on setting a very, very high score to kick off the week. You've won yourself that smart speaker. Neil, don't worry, don't leave empty-handed. You get the Radio 2 coffee mug. And Adam, I will send you the question sheet because you've got a full house. So well done and take care.
Thanks.
You very much.
Cheers.
Well, that's it. The first 10 to the top this week is done. And if you fancy being the next contestant to step up to the plate, all you've got to do is email me. Put your name, your contact details and why we should pick you for 10 to the top. And send us an email, 10tothetop@bbc.co.uk. And you never know, it could be you. And if you're passing a smart speaker today, remember what you need to shout. Ask BBC Sounds to play 10 to the top.
10 to the top on Radio 2.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.